We live in a democratic republic. The idea is that we hire people through democratic elections to represent us in every government that serves us, from the city council to the U.S. Congress. Representation is key. People must feel like they are being truly represented, or that they at least have an equal say in who should represent them. The most basic challenge and responsibility, then, in this form of government is the act of dividing us up into districts that should be represented. First, the districts must have roughly the same number of people. It just would not be fair to one person if his congressional district had far more people than another person's. And there are other laws. The Federal Voting Rights Act, for example, prohibits discrimination against minority communities. If there's a neighborhood that is primarily black, for example, it can't be divided too much so that it is harder to organize for representation. The districts should also preserve the geographic integrity of cities, counties, neighborhoods, and communities of interest. In California, districts are supposed to be compact so that they're not drawn so weirdly that one neighborhood is in a different district than one right next to it, but then a farther one is in the first one's district. But people move. Every 10 years, the federal government does a census count to track that. In California, bipartisan independent redistricting commissions are required to appoint a diverse group to look at the data and potential maps and listen to people so that they can come up with new districts that follow all this criteria. Back in 2010, for example, the city of San Diego added a ninth city council district. It ended up combining the affluent area of Kensington with City Heights, an incredibly diverse community with high rates of poverty. And it moved downtown from the District 2 representation to District 3. It created an urban core in District 3 and a coastal neighborhoods district for District 2. This required a lot of new maps and discussion. This year, as the new census count comes to an end and Democrats continue to gain an advantage, redistricting is becoming less partisan. That does not mean, though, arguments about redistricting will stop. There will be many conversations about how new boundaries, for everything from school districts to city councils to Congress, should better serve communities with common interests and backgrounds and improve representation in government. Because representation is the heart of our republic, and it starts with what specific area government leaders actually represent.